Oh, cool. It's like grandma. Another kind of walker.
Keeping good distance.
Yeah, personally. I'm looking up the name of the Star Wars big walking machine. It's called AT-ACT, Attack Walker.
Yeah.
So anyway, I was curious how creative naming they did.
Uh-huh.
It's funny how every kind of floor acts different.
Yeah.
Holmes was going more to the right, so I don't know what to expect from that.
How do you tell when it's gone the right distance? Is it just it's gone?
It's got a counter. Well, it's doing five stands. Whoa, and now it's far enough. It does five stands and then takes
I have
a look,
to move.
And then does five more and does it like 16 times.
Oh, and it doesn't turn, it just goes in the other direction. It makes sense. Nice.
It's a lot better backwards and forwards for some reason. I don't understand. Now it's trying to kind of recover a little bit on turning around. It's feeling kind of okay. It's still too far away. It's supposed to be between 8 and 12 inches roughly, so it's already way too far from the wall. But
it heard you.
What I like about Lego is you can keep rebuilding stuff over and over.
And the other thing about Lego is you have to keep rebuilding stuff.
Ah, it's true. Now what?
It's a 50-50 chance of hitting the wall.
Aww.
I think it's a winner, though.
Last time what happened was the little pegs here, I had to glue them. I put a touch of, well, I tried white glue, and it didn't work that good, so then I put a touch of super glue on each of these joints because it was coming apart. Turn the steering wheel. Give a little steering wheel here. And then I usually start it off around. I have a calibration thing for distance, but it should correct itself good enough. And it has three routines. It's like a switch statement. If it's too far, it's got a happy face on it, which means it's the right distance right now. And it has an arrow, meaning the arrow is show up for some reason. But anyway, if it's beyond a certain distance, like let's say 12 inches, then it tries to steer and go that direction. And if it's less than 8, then it steers and goes the other way.
You don't seem to be straining on this scope. You don't have any direction
one time. I'm measuring just once every 4. Otherwise, it goes very slow. So I wanted to, like, every 4 or 5 motions, and then it remeasures. Like, you see it kind of pausing at that. When it does pause, it's when it's making
it. What I mean is that if you are stopped already, you could just make several readings in different positions and calculate actual line of the wall.
Oh, what happened last time was it was going a little crazy because the batteries were getting weak, so I put in new batteries and it went too, they don't have a regulator in there, so it started to go too fast and tipped over.
Oh!
That's kind of silly that right now I have it kind of in the midpoint.
Should see the wall, huh?
Actually, it's got an advantage being this close to the wall because now it's going to keep trying to turn that way. Last time it got too far away from the wall. Here it has a better fighting chance now.
Yeah.
But that's one mistake they didn't put into the regulator. Because then if you have strong batteries, if it goes from 6 to 9 volts in order to operate, the operating range. When it's below 6, it won't turn motors that much.
Yeah, well, my kid ended up with it.
Yeah.
And what kind of brake is it?
It's the double A.
Oh, really good double A?
Yeah.
A lot of them.
Attachment you can buy for it. It's rechargeable batteries and they'll last about 3 or 4 years. But they're $90 or so.
When it gets too far away from the wall, does it still see the wall and notice that it's too far away?
Well, yeah, it's trying to
or
make
is
up
it
the
outside
difference.
Of its sensor range?
Well, no, it's still trying to go back. Stop. It's just that it opens up.
Yeah.